Yes, let's start today's session. So first let us discuss about JLP treatment of joint life policy. Now, so here, my dear friends, if you see that, in a treatment of JLP, you have to think of the position. So here, things are, my dear friends, JLP means it is an insurance policy taken by partnership firm on partners. It is an insurance policy taken by firm on behalf of partners, that is on partners they have taken. So that means insurance policy will be paid by firm. So therefore, since the policy premium was paid by the firm on maturity, also the policy amount will be received by the firm. So because out of business profits the premium has been paid, so therefore on maturity also the policy amount will be received by the firm. So therefore, once it is the money is received for the firm, it is available for everyone. So therefore, even if it is a 1 rupee is received, yeah, if the profit is there, it is distributable to all the partners. So therefore, you can't say it is taken on A, therefore it is a yes JLP, therefore I have to give to only A. No. It is, even it is a individually, if they have taken, or collectively if they have taken, whatever it might be, on payment of premium, it is paid by business profits, premium has been paid. That is, the profits available to partners, out of that only premium is paid. Correct? Then on maturity, so the firm will receive the money. Therefore, if the firm is received, it is available for everyone, even though it has been taken on individual. So therefore, so policy can be taken, my dear friends. Insurance policy can be taken either it is a individually or collectively. So if it is individually, means, my dear friends, if it is individually taken, means like, so A separately, on B separately, and on C separately. Yeah, collectively means one policy covering A, B, and C, all three partners, all together, one policy. So this is one policy for all partner. So this is individual policies. Correct? Now, so what will happen in this case of individual policy? Let us think of. Now, if it is individual policy, means this is on taking insurance policy or on insuring and holding period. In the holding period, just I will keep on paying the insurance premium. That's it, my dear friends. But on maturity, suppose if it is a change in constitution, that is, retirement or death, correct? So because in admission case I will take a new policy, therefore there is no disturbance in other case, but only in case of change in constitution, that is a retirement or death, what will happen? Now the policy, whatever that relationship occurred, that was break. So because of that, the policy either it has to mature or surrender, things we have to do it. So this is the name itself, it is called as joint life policy. Correct? Now if you would have come across LIC, life insurance policy, when it will be matured? When the policy will mature? Mature means policy will mature. That is a life policy. Life policy means always will mature. Mature, whichever is earliest letter. Policy. So our regular class students, when policy will mature? A, on expiry of term. Term means period. Expiry of term. Or B, occurrence of event. Event means death. Yeah, occurrence of death, correct? So for this, whatever these two is there, whichever is earlier, whichever is earlier. So that means you have taken an insurance policy, life insurance policy for 10 years. So, and you are alive, policy 10 year was matured. That means you will get full amount. Mature means full amount. Mature means full amount. Full amount, because for life insurance policy, our life itself has been given as a security. So therefore, either on expiry of the term, or suppose 10 years is a contract, but before that, the person has died naturally, then policy will be automatically mature. Correct? Only in case of death, you will get full period, full amount, or on expiry of the term only, you will get the full amount. Correct? Now, here also, life is a maturity. Therefore, my dear friends, therefore, here also, look out, here also, note. So, on death, policy will mature. On death, policy will mature. And on retirement. So retirement is not a death, correct? Only change in relationship. That is bond, whatever A, B, C are the three partner. Now imagine C has retired. That means here in after only A and B, correct? So for the signing and all, he will not come. So therefore here in after, so what happened? Whatever the old policy, A, B, C and C is there, that policy bond, I have to give it back and I have to take the new bond. That is A and B, I have to take the new bond. So therefore, so in case of this, your policy has to be surrender. In case of death, policy will mature. Mature means you will receive full amount. So here only it is not full amount. It is less than amount assured. Less than amount assured. You will not receive full amount. Only surrender value. So it is less than amount assured. Less than amount assured will be there. Got it? So now, when we will receive full amount? Only in case of death. So in case of all other, except death, my difference, in all other case, you have to go with surrender value. Correct? So what is surrender value means? So as per the bond, when you take the insurance policy, so in a bond, the terms and conditions will be there. In that surrender value, the company would have been mentioned. That's the insurance company, they will mention. So suppose if you have taken a policy now 1 year, correct? So after 1 year, if you come and look out, you have taken 10 year policy. Yeah. So every year, imagine insurance premium is, so premium is, for example, 8,000. Premium is 8,000 per annum, and you have to pay 10 years into 10 years. That means 80,000 you will pay plus 20,000 in the form of interest I will give. Total maturity amount is 1 lakh. Total maturity amount is 1 lakh. 10 years is the duration, for example. 10 years is the duration. Correct? So now what will happen? Every year you will keep on paying 8,000 as a premium. 8,000 as a insurance premium, 8,000 as a premium. Like this, you will keep on paying. Correct? But imagine after four years, suppose if it is partner has retired or death, correct? So that time this policy, whatever the bond I have taken, that has to be closed. If it is a death, I will get, immaterial of the amount paid, I will get full value 1 lakh. Correct? But suppose in case of retirement, so that time, or retirement or in any other case, suppose if I go and surrender today, what value I will get? That value will be mentioned in a policy itself as per surrendering values. Correct? Surrender value means look out. So here, first year you will pay 8,000 premium. So in a policy, they would have say, first year if you command surrender, I will give nil. Year one, I will give nil because already contracted. Second year, another 8,000 you will pay. Total 16,000 is what the amount you pay. But second year, if you command surrender, I will give only 1,000. Yeah. So third year, another 8,000 premiums you would have paid. But third year end, if you command surrender, this was company's policy is saying. Because if you wait for 10 years, you will get full amount. Correct? Bond you have taken, but if you are command surrendering, giving back before that period, I will give only this. That is the amount what they have contracted. If you command surrender this policy, I will give only this. Correct? So in a pre, it is like pre-decided. Pre-decided as per the bond on contract. Suppose here, 3,000. If Y4, if you command surrender, I will give 8,000. Like it is its terms and condition. its terms and conditions based on PV factor is known, based on that they will calculate. But I'm damn sure, so surrender value is very, very much less than what is actually you paid. Yeah, if you wait for full period, then only it will be benefit, you will get full value, otherwise you will not. Got it? That value is what we call it as surrender value. But on surrender, on giving the policy, either in case of death, I will get full value. In case of retirement or other way, if I give back the policy, give back the bond, I will get only surrender value. Correct? But whatever the amount you get, that will be your consideration what you received on account of joint life policy on maturity or surrender, whatever it might be. That is what inflow of cash. Keep in mind. Now, suppose in case of, my difference, look out. In case of, if you, what is the benefit if you take individually, if you take, suppose if it's a death, if it's a death or retirement on account of change in constitution. So suppose, imagine if it is A has died or retired. Correct? Only his policy alone will affect, others, these two will not affect. This will continue as it is. Only the outgoing or in outgoing or this is whomsoever it might be, A and B, either death or this, only his policy alone will affect. If it is a death, for A's policy, I will get full amount. If it is a retirement, I will get surrender value. That's how it will work. Got it? Suppose if I have taken collectively, that's a one policy covering all, the entire policy will affect. Suppose if A has died, complete ABC, also this policy I have to surrender. This is mature or surrender. Complete policy will surrender or complete policy will mature. Got it? So policy can be taken either individually or collectively. Yeah, so this is one point. Second one, so on account of JLP, so on account of death, policy will mature, full amount I will get. In any other case, I will get only surrender value. Surrender value is nothing but as per contract between policyholder as well as company at the time of taking the policy itself, it has been agreed in terms and condition. If you come and surrender in a premature period, how much they will refund. Got it? So that at that value. So either it's a full value or surrender value, whatever it might be. If it's inflow of cash, for that entry has to be passed. At the time of payment, I have to pass the entry. So this is holding period entries, then on maturity. These are the two period entries will come. Next, if individually policies are taken, then any one change, suppose if any one partner, if he died or retired, only his policy alone will affect, other two partners will not affect. Yeah. So suppose if it is collectively taken, then the entire policy will affect. So therefore, entire policy is supposed to surrender. So this is what the introduction to JLP. So JLP is nothing but, my difference, it's an insurance policy taken by the firm on behalf of on its partner. So premium will be paid by the firm out of business profits. Therefore, the profit which is available to partners, out of that premium has been paid. So therefore, on maturity also, firm will receive, and even if it's a year has died, money will come to firm. So this amount will be whatever the on his head, what amount we have assured, that amount will be received by the firm, and it will be distributed to all the partners in their PSR. That's how it will work. Now let's go to the accounting treatment. Accounting treatment of JLP. So JLP, now here, joint life policy. So here, my dear friends, for the purpose of accounting, so it has been classified into three parts, into three types. So number one is, my dear friends, here, number one is JLP life policy, correct? Insurance premium is treated as, first point is expense. Insurance premium is treated as expense. Second one is as an investment. Third one is as sinking fund. These are the three methods. Yeah. So in each of the method, my difference, whether if it is treated as an expense or investment, whatever it might be, so there might be two periods we have to think of across your page. Yeah, if possible, so this insurance premium treatment, open in a horizontal page. This entries alone, what we are going to do it. So now, So in this, we have the two components, my friends. Two components. Part one is holding period entry. Holding period. In all the case, holding period entries like this. Part two. This is holding period. Thereafter, in a part two, on maturity. On maturity, some three entries will come, due entry, this and all. So in a holding period, either one entry or maximum two entry might be there. That's all. So first you complete holding period. Thereafter, whatever balance portion is there, then you can use maturity. For your information, just I have shown the picturization. That's it. Now, if it is insurance premium, what I have paid is treated as an expense. Correct? Expense means insurance premium account debit to bank account on payment, and year end it will be charged off to P&L. Like that, it will come. So now under that A on payment of premium. On payment of premium, entry is, my dear friends, insurance premium account debit to bank account. Since it is treated as an expense at the year end, entry number B, year end. So this I have to transfer to P&L. Therefore, P&L account debit to insurance premium account. So note, nothing will appear in balance sheet. Correct? Now let's go to the maturity entry. Keep in mind, in balance sheet nothing is appeared, so everything, whatever I have paid the premium, completely I have charged off to P&L. Keep in mind, completely I have charged off to P&L. Now, on maturity, this is the entry which I pass. Suppose if 10 years, out of that 9 years also, even if I go for maturity also, if nothing happens, completely for 10 years, if I wait also, up to 10 year, up to holding period, I will pass. This is the entry. Correct? Last 10th year, when I am receiving the money back for the policy, that time what we call it as maturity. That too after 10th year. So now on maturity, when I receive, correct? So here write it as either surrender value or full. Surrender value or maturity. Maturity value. Either it is a surrender value or maturity value, entry is the same. Whatever the amount you get, usually full value if you get, it is like profit. If you get surrender value, it is usually loss. Keep in mind. So here, whatever I get completely, since in the balance sheet nothing is appeared, my difference, I have to create JLP separately first. So therefore, entry, first I have to pass a due entry. Entry is, so insurance company account debit to JLP account. This is what maturity amount or surrender value, whatever amount I get that. Next, entry number B is transfer, distribution, allocation, whatever the JLP premium is there, that I have to distribute to partners. So distribution of JLP to partners. Partners, entry, JLP account debit to partners. Partners capital account in there. This is in old PSR. This is for old partners. Next, entry number C is receipt. Receipt entry is bank account debit to insurance company account. These are the entries. Insurance company account. This is receipt entry. In method one, when it is JLP treated as an expense, yeah, holding period and on maturity. Now, if you come for, if it is JLP is treated as an investment, JLP is treated as an investment. So now here, same like holding period entry first part, on payment of premium, my difference here, JLP is treated as an investment, that is JLP investment. It will be treated as like, it is not treated as like insurance premium paid as an expense. It, instead that it will 10,000 what I paid, I will treat it as 10,000 worth of investments is purchased. Correct? So investments is an asset. So therefore, investments is an asset. Therefore, when I pay the premium, I feel it as investment is purchased. That investment name is JLP investment. So entry on payment of premium is JLP investment. JLP investment account, JLP investment account debit, JLP investment account debit to bank account on payment of premium at the year end. At the year end, no entry because it is not a nominal account to transfer to P&L. Yeah, note in balance sheet. JLP investment will appear at asset side. JLP investment will appear at asset side. Yeah. So now let's go to the on maturity entry. On maturity, since here investment is created, my dear friends, at the time of payment of premium, I treat it as a purchase of investment. Now, at the time of giving back, either it's a maturity or surrender, I have to treat it as like sale of investment. Therefore, to the extent of sale of investment, to the extent of book value of investment, I have to cancel the investments. Correct? Over and above, if any is there, that is the profit that only I have to distribute to the partners. So therefore, on maturity, first due entry, whatever be the amount, entry is insurance company account debit to JLP investment account. This is to the extent of book value. This is maturity value to JLP account. So look out, JLP investment is different. JLP is a reserves and surplus. So here, assuming profit. If it is surrender value, means loss will be there. I would have debited. Yeah. So this is a due entry. Now, whatever JLP is there that I have to distribute to partner, entry is JLP account debit. JLP account debit to partners capital account, that also in old PSR. So whatever JLP that surplus is there, this surplus I have to distribute to partners. Next, on receipt, same entry. Bank account debit to insurance company account. Yeah. Now let's go to the third category. JLP is treated as a sinking fund. So therefore, JLP is treated as a sinking fund, means, my dear friends, so one sinking fund account we have to create, another one is sinking fund investment account we have to maintain. Got it? So it is created as a fund. So here, sinking fund account is called as JLP reserve account. Sinking fund investment account is called as JLP investment account. Yeah. So now let us go for entry. During the holding period, when premium is paid. So premium is paid, it is a normal, it's like purchase of investment. Entry is, first entry, JLP investment account debit to bank account. Next, at the year end, whatever amount I paid equal to that from the P&L, I have to transfer to JLP reserve. Therefore entry. So P&L account debit to JLP reserve account. Note, in balance sheet, both. So JLP reserve at the liability side and JLP investment asset side will appear.
asset side will appear. Next, on maturity, first entry, it is like sale of investment. Entry is insurance company account debit to JLP investment account to the extent of book value. If any more than that maturity, that is JLP, whatever the profit is there, my difference, that profit I have to take to JLP reserve account. JLP reserve account profit. So this is what the